Okay. Good morning. Just a brief overview of what we are teaching here at the University of Nottingham in the area of space engineering. So first of all, I give you a brief overview of the main module we are teaching. So we have a module that is called Introduction to Space, where the idea is to involve the student in the design and approach to the space system, giving them as a goal the design of a preliminary satellite mission, mostly based on CubeSat standard. After, we have the module at the year four with spacecraft system and design, where they are learning how to design the single system, and they need to provide a kind of PDR and CDR analysis of the satellite system. We have a group project that is called Aerospace Group Design and Project. This is for the all the aerospace engineering in the MEng program. And the module is divided in aeronautical and space projects. In the space project, we are giving them complex mission, like for example, to land to moon, to special crater, or Mars mission, and so on. After that, they of course can choose their individual project, and they can decide to do some space project as their individual project. In the BING level, we normally ask them to perform some analysis. In the MING project, they are involved in real project. Mostly, our approach is based on the hands-on education, so we want to teach them how to develop a specific system, so having a space system approach, in particular involve them in real project that can be supported by ESA. For example, we are right now being selected for flyer thesis mission. So we have a group of students that are working in an astropharmaceutical payload that will be boarded inside the International Space Station launched next year. We want to have them preparing and proposing also projects for Rexus, BEXUS, Zero-G, and the other ESA call. In general, the idea can be proposed by the student, can be proposed by the advisor, or can be also something that is a mix of idea. In general, what we are using in our teaching are we have a different facility. We have that after you will see. We have a small satellite facility where we have mostly a 1U CubeSat, but also a 3U and 2U CubeSat that we developed by our own. And we are having an Earth magnetic field simulator. We have an air bearing table. We have a sun simulator, and also three U CubeSat bus that we can use to implement our payload. We have a small ground station based in UHF, VHF, and S-band on top of one of our roof in the main campus. And this is used to teach the student not just to receive satellite, but also to operate. Ideally, in the near future, when we will have our own satellite in orbit, they will receive data from their own satellite. For now, we are using radiometer satellite and existing open source satellite. Also, we have a bunch of simulation software and hardware that we can use. We have the possibility to access to the honeycomb chamber. We have a lot of facility for manufacturing for simulating. In particular, we introduced a few years ago the FlatSat activity, where the students are learning how to work with electronics with simple components, mostly using Raspberry Pi and Arduino. And we have a specific laboratory that we are running. We started this activity a couple of years ago, so at the year three level. So right now we should have all of them trained, but since they are going in industrial year and so on, we are still checking before we started the lecture this year if all of them are trained. This activity now is not anymore under our control, let's say, but this has been taken as example to teach electronics at the first year. So starting from last year, students at year one are starting to learn more about electronics. Following this activity, we had a couple of satellites designed by students and completely assembled. So we had WormSail and TemboSat. WormSail was a satellite that had the idea to study biomedical payload inside the satellite, but also using a huge sail to do the orbiting using origami techniques to open the mechanism. And TemboSat was a proposal from the student. Was a 1U CubeSat with the idea to track elephant over Kenyan, and they designed and manufactured the prototype just using 300 pounds. Of course, this is an example of the antenna deployment mechanism, but it was one part of the work done by the student as their individual project. And here you can see the antenna deployer and the drug cell that also was designed as an individual project by one of the students that was carrying on. Similar projects are carried by the other student. Right now they are more concentrated in the activity related to the system that is going to the International Space Station, the VITA mission. Mostly we are two people teaching here, so me, I have a small background with different student project and satellite launched in Italy and Brazil, and also US involving student, and Nisha that has a background more in flight mechanics and astrodynamics. And these are the typical text that we are using that all of you know, so like the SMAD, also the CubeSat handbook, and the Fortescue, and so on. In terms of assessment, that is the key aspect of today, our idea is to try to involve the student in having an overall idea of all the space missions, so just not consider just the satellite, but consider also the other segment. In general, starting from introduction to space, the idea is that they are thinking about the goal of the mission, what will be the payload, and designing the orbit to satisfy the mission. After they start to identify the mission operation, the spacecraft, the launcher, the ground segment, the communication architecture. We give them some constraint, like for example, their mission should not be to cost more than $1 million pound, have 1 year developing time from the kickoff, using the IDC rules, and have some other characteristic like at least 1 year of mission operation. From this constraint, they need to design the mission that they can choose. In particular, during this last, so we started this activity just 5 years ago when I joined the university, and this 5 year we changed a little bit our assessment, also following the feedback from the student. And initially, I gave them a very huge workload, giving a huge coursework where they were supposed to design one specific mission, doing all the mission analysis, but also all the system analysis. Each individual student have to design their own mission. They can decide whatever they want to do. And after they implement the mission analysis using specific tools as SDK, GMAT, also BAP and other, and after they do the system and mission analysis. We change a little bit after the feedback, and we reduce the fees only doing the mission analysis. And after we found out that it was better to give them specific tasks and prepare them with specific tools that they need to satisfy. As an example, I want to show you one of the projects that was run this year, one of the coursework that they did. This is an example of the coursework. They start to decide the mission and the name of the mission, and after they produce, this is the project description. Something that I found really difficult to teach them, that the one key aspect is the definition of the requirement and objective. Sometimes they start with a very nice idea, interesting, but they don't know exactly what they are doing. So it's really important to to keep them focused on what they have to do, what is the objective and the goal. For this reason, AIMS objective is a huge part of the mark that we are giving them. So in terms of long term and short term, so the requirement, normally we ask to fill also a specific file where they put also the requirement and give them number and in order to be able to track the requirement constraint. And after they start with the analysis, with some simulation, in particular about the ground track and the revisit time, design the ground segment, the launch segment, and do the space debris mitigation, and describe and analyze the payload that can satisfy the mission goal. Yes? Okay, this is not visible. I can show you later an example. It's out of the my knowledge. In terms of the year four, first of all, you need to consider that in year three, we have normally around 85 students, 80-90 students, and they are mostly from aerospace and mechanics engineering. For year four, we found out that they were really upset about the idea of having group projects, and at the same time, we were trying to give them more activity, doing something more. So we come out with the idea of having something mixed, that is the team project, where they are working as an individual for their own project, but at the same time, they are working as a group. So they have a mission, and the mission is split in subsystem. Each student have to take care of one specific system. Mostly they are split in terms of structure, PS, TTC, OBDH. I cannot give you an example. So previous year we had four different assessments. So we had a class test, coursework one and two. One was a PDR level, the two was a CDR level. They were really upset and too many assignments, and so we had to reduce that. This year we introduced something different, and we collected all the coursework in one single element where they have to do system design, lab activity, and certification for the SDK. In general, the idea is that in the next, sorry, I'm running a little bit because we are late, in the next coursework, sorry, about the coursework, in this case, we introduced something new. They don't have to design a mission, but they need to analyze something, a mission that failed, in particular a small satellite mission, and they need to understand why that mission failed, introducing why, in which phase of the operational operation of the system the mission was failed, and why, in which phase of the design was something wrong that caused the failure. So the next step will be for the to do something more standard, so in order to be able to mark 80-90 exam really quickly, and add more practical activity in year three, and but add more advanced activity for year four, in particular introducing more failure analysis, operational manual, but also giving them some assembly integration test and verification activity to do. In particular, we found that they are really weak on the thermal analysis, and so the idea is to drive them in a more technical analysis related to the thermal system. Thank you. Any questions?